all set up, ready to paint my little brass pot up here. There's my paints uncapped next to my palette. I'll be painting that brass pot. All my other items that I might need are over here, including my napkins and the brushes I think I might need. And I'm ready to paint on this board. So I'm going to start by mixing up the dark side of the pot, which will have these two, the ultramarine blue and the umber in it. And I'm going to put a little bit of one of these yellow ochres in it, just because I want that color in there, because it's got to be in other parts of the pot. So, all right, for right now, I'm going to leave that like that. That's going to be my little pile of dark. I'll probably need more of it, but until I'm sure about the hue, I'm going to stop right there with that. I want to mix up two piles. Oof, that's a lot. Of this brighter yellow ochre by. This is a Graham paint. I like this because oftentimes I want that bright ochre. Some ochres are really dull. This one actually does not look quite like that pot. That pot has too much green in it. So I'm going to add, this is where I'm going to see if I can make do without adding my sap green to it. And now I'm starting to get to more of a green color, as you see, I hope. That over here, and now I'm going to mix up a darker version of an in-between value of those two. So that's a nice middle value. I'll stick that right there so you can see them compared. So I got a light, medium, and dark value. But we've also got to go into some more of these gold colors for the highlight. So I want to see. This gives you a beautiful, bright, warm highlight to mix that cad yellow medium into it. It's nice and creamy, whereas actually with this Indian yellow, that's another beautiful warm highlight. And it's cooler, I think. So this probably is going to make more sense for that almost lemony looking brass pot. Yeah, I think so. So let's put a little bit of that off to the side here. And then I want to make it much more. saturated color. I'm going to use some of that. Okay, and then for the cloth, it's actually going to be a lot like this with a lot more white in it, I think. So let's see, I got that with this. So I'm going to take a lot of that because I need... It's so nice when you don't have a whole lot of colors to choose from so that it's easy to remember how you got to something. It's just so much more of a joy to paint when you're not just struggling with and fighting with colors and getting frustrated with it. Trust me, you want to minimize your frustrations. So that's getting to be a nice color for the cloth, maybe a little bluer than that. And then I'll add a bunch of white to it. I didn't bother to put it right in the middle. Still cooling it down. That's what I'm looking for, right there for the cloth. Now when I get it up there, I might think, oh, it's too bright and I might have to neutralize it. But for now, I'm gonna let that stay for my cloth color. And I'm actually going to, that's the hue that I can mix with more white if I need to. So now I'm going to clean this up and I'll be ready to paint. So the first thing I'm going to do is make a wash using a little bit of my umber and my ultramarine blue, and I'm using just this number 4 hog hair bristle brush. Dip it into the terp. So I'm going to basically, I don't even want to say draw, but I'm going to mass in my pot with this dark color on my canvas now. But I want it to be real washy, and this is going to address just the darks. And we're going to leave the light of the canvas as the lights. So the subject is going to fill a space about like this. I'm going to paint this pot smaller than actual size. I prefer to do it actual size, but we don't always get to. But I don't ever like to make it larger than actual size. So anyway, it's going to be up in here. So I'm going to start by just massing in where this pot lives and about how big it is. So it's going to be somewhere in here. Wasn't that easy? So easy. I'm almost done. And then we've got the, right away I start heading into a little bit darker with the blue to address the ellipse on the inside of the pot. Where are my darks? Where are my lights? Like I said, the tone of the canvas is going to represent the light here. So all I'm doing is taking this umber and the blue and finding, oops, you don't want it too runny or that's what happens. It won't stick nicely like that. Still got a lot of terp in that brush, but it's coming. It's hard for me to see from at this angle. I think the camera sees it better than I can see it right now. Very hard to do. But you can see that it's starting to evolve into the shape of that pot. We have dark up to this little foot. It's all just kind of dark in here. And then a shadow comes out here. And then on the other side of that little foot, it's dark again. So that little foot just kind of peeks into the light right about there. We'll address that more later, but just thought I'd point that out. So then we've got these other planes that catch the light differently, and the most light we have is concentrated right in here. Okay. Start getting darker, and I'm using now this pile that I mixed. I think it's got to go bluer. Always checking to see if your ellipse is crooked or not. Get it up there if it is. Ooh, they're hard to fix later. I'm feeling pretty good about that, but I think I'm looking down upon it a little bit more than that. So I'm going to drop that just a little. So you see, I'm getting a really pretty good underpainting going here, so that when it comes time to put the light in it, it's just easy. I'm actually smoothing out some of this so that it's so I'm always painting the finish, so to speak. And now let's pop some color into it and see what happens. So I know it's going to feel awfully green. And so I'm going to reach into my other ochre just a little. This is that duller ochre I have out. I'm mixing a little bit of this dark into this color.
absolutely get boosted. So you always want to make sure that you've got enough medium in your brush so that it's going to unload nicely for you. Here I want to now I'm reaching into a little bit of my red and a little bit of my cad yellow medium, just to feel that little bit of warmth, because this all feels so green, and that just feels a little warmer to me in there, and yet it's not far away from this kind of dusty bluish looking highlight here. See? Back and forth with. And that's actually too bright. I'm gonna kill that a little bit. Okay, now right away it's important to start popping in these highlights because you're able to see what your extremes of values are. So I'm going to go ahead and put in a really powerful highlight there. I'm going to diminish that, but for now it's there. I feel like I need I'm going to mix up a tiny bit of this more powerful, it's a colder yellow, with this is yellow light. Oh yeah, it is open. It's just a colder yellow. And I know it's in there, but I'm always afraid to get too much of it in there because it just starts looking too green. But I'm mixing up a pile of that. Feel a little bit of now I really want to create a little more warmth in that brass. And this is where my Indian yellow comes in very handy. It's just such a beautiful glazing color. Here's some too. Very soon now I'm going to get my background going. Mm-hmm. this is kind of a turquoisey color. I just, mixed up there a little bit. Okay, now I'm going to go into the background. It is time. It is well time. I should have done this probably sooner. Let's see. Okay. Raise that up. Yep, I'm going to have to bring this up a little, I think. Shovel paint, because I want to draw a line. So, and I don't know how long has this been, about 20 minutes? I've gotten to a fairly decent representation of what's there. I've got a ways to go. I want to continue to warm up some of this. Gotta be careful though. This is going to actually see some of this green cloth. So, free to build a little bit of that in here somewhere. There where it's pointing down at it. I feel like there's just this really pretty blue down there. Okay, so I can't avoid this any longer. I've got to bring this up. Do I? Yes, a little bit. I'm going to switch to a round brush because I want to just do this little stroke there. That was not real swift. Not a real great move there. Nor was it the best color or value. I'm going to do it again with a little more control. It's actually so subtle that you want to sculpt that down then. So it's really, really subtle. You see, over there we've got, we've got something going on, not sure what, but there's a nice little highlight sitting on this thing, and there. Sculpt that down a little bit. I'm going to put a bright note of I can get it in there where I want it. Cad yellow medium. Really bright little highlight right down there. Ah. No, that wasn't what I wanted to do. It's very hard to stay out of the way of the camera and do this. So I can do it again, paint it like I mean it, as I so often like to say. There, that's a better highlight. And then we've got some funkiness down here. So that funkiness just kind of mostly it consists of highlights this is the light shining through the foot. In with some background color and sculpt this in a little bit more. Once you get everything kind of where you want it, you can start going back and looking for more of the brass color. Building it in here and there. This actually drops from here down. And then we've got a number of that we can do if we want to do all of them. We don't have to do all of the design lines in this pot. Some of them. Design our own pot, so to speak. Then I'm not going to do too much more on this. I want to put a brighter highlight here. I can get it off of here. There. Actually, I'm going to try to spread that highlight, but I'm going to pick up dark color on my brush so that I don't get it up in here. I'm just going to move that over a little. See, I just can just kind of drag it. I'm not sure what's going on with that, but then I'm going to drag it from underneath as well and go this way with it. And there you've got a nice little highlight along the lip of that thing.